summer. Music hitting your heart, cause I know you got a soul.
Hey,
listen if you're missing, y'all. Swinging while I'm singing.
Hey,
giving what you're getting. Knowing what I'm knowing. While the black band's sweating. In the rhythm I'm rolling. Gotta give us what we want. Gotta give us what we need.
Hey,
our freedom of speech is freedom of death. We got to fight the powers that be. Fight the power. 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 We got to fight the powers that be. Algorithms designed to bounce with health and mental lines. Designed to fill your mind.
Well, looks like that's all we're gonna get out of that road today, because we have cars in front of us. So guys, welcome to another episode of Moto HD DK. And I'm sure you guys have noticed by now that my bike sounds super different, super awesome, and loud. It's because I got a new bike. Psych. Nah, I didn't get a new bike. Same bike, which I love. My Honda CBR 600 RR Fiona, which I love very much. I actually put a new exhaust on her. Let's see if I can get you a quick view of it. That's not gonna work. How about the other way? That's not gonna work. I can't get you guys a quick view of it. But I put on a Two Brothers exhaust and it sounds awesome. I'm probably gonna do another bonus episode for you guys later, so you can just see and hear how sick it sounds. Sounds awesome. The only real downside to it is that I gotta like scream when I motovlog now. I gotta scream at the top of my lungs because it's so freaking loud. But I love it. It's almost like a straight pipe. There's like no baffle. It's pretty cool. I love this bike even more now. Oh my gosh. Oh, it feels so good. I gotta go to the track soon. This is like getting insane. Speaking of needing to go to the track, as you might have guessed by the title to this episode, I got pulled over. I got a ticket. I'll explain to you guys the situation of how I got said ticket, but really it was my own fault. Really stupid how I got it. And if you can believe it, I wasn't even going that fast. I was going fast, but I wasn't going fast enough to warrant a cop pulling over a motorcycle for a ticket. I don't know where you live, but in Maryland, when cops see bikers going really fast, they don't even bother most of the time. They're like, you know what? There's no way I'm gonna catch that dude. So I'm gonna let the speed cameras get him or the helicopter get him. They do that a lot in Maryland. They send the helicopter after you. And I've seen it so many times of helicopters chasing down bikers, or really street riders, specifically crotch rocket street riders, sport bike riders, quote unquote, because they're just too damn fast for a cruiser, you know, they're too damn fast for a police cruiser. So, the way it happened was, I was going down a road, much like this road you see here, except I was in a different part of Maryland, the road was wider, and it was kind of like a highway, really, except it was in the woods. And really early morning, I just got back from my girl's place, and I was like, wow, my bike feels really good. Let me, you know, go for a quick speed run on the way home. So I'm on a road just like this. Speed limit's 55. Much wider, less stuff around you. It's really just farmland. She lives in like the boonies, so there's really nothing but farmland around you. There's nothing to hit. There's no real danger aside from deer. And it was really early in the morning, so I wasn't, you know, too concerned about it. But I was booking it, and I see this white car coming towards me, like in the distance. So I was like, okay, what the hell is that? Whatever, I'm just gonna keep on riding like I normally do. So I'm just cruising. I'm doing about 80 miles an hour. I'm cruising at 80 miles an hour and I'm just, you know, chilling. So the car comes up and right when it gets near me, it turns his lights on real quick. And I was like, ah, crap, it's a cop. But he turns his lights on, then he turns them off, like really fast. And I was like, oh, okay. I guess that was a warning to slow my little booty down. So what did I do? I slowed my little booty down. I don't know if it was the morning or just I wasn't as alert as I normally am. I decided for some strange reason, nah, don't take, you know, a couple of side roads to get home to avoid any more cops or even the one I just passed. Just keep going, you're fine. So I kept going, and wouldn't you know, as soon as I get by the elementary school, at this point I'm doing like 35 miles an hour because this is a school zone. I really don't like the speed in school zones. What's up, good sir? I really don't like the speed in, you know, school zones or anything like that. I like to be careful generally. So I'm cruising at like 35 miles an hour. Another cop comes up from in front of me now, and he passes me, and then he does a quick U-ey. Once he did that U-ey, I was like, ah, damn it all. I already knew that was it. I knew that was it, and I didn't even bother. So he followed me for like 10 seconds and immediately turned his lights on, and I was like, son of a gun. So I pull over to the 7-Eleven, right? Pulled over to 7-Eleven. He gets out his car. He was like, license and registration, sir. And I was like, damn it all, damn it all. Not 5 minutes later, the cop I passed the first time around rolls on up past this guy. Excuse me, good sir. Not 5 minutes later, the cop passed the first time, rolls up, and he's like, hey, how you doing? And I was like, you know, it's pretty good. He was like, I clocked you doing 82 back there. And I was like, really? You know, whenever a cop starts talking to you about speed and whatnot, you always gotta act surprised. Wow, really? I didn't know I was doing 80. Did you know I was doing 80? So we played that little game, but they were actually really, really nice cops. I've never seen cops act in a well-civilized manner. They weren't doing the good cop, bad cop. They were just saying, hey, we clocked you doing 82. We're gonna run your plates, see what we get. So they ran my plates, it came up clean, you know, Moto HDDK style. So my plates came up clean, obviously. Never actually had a ticket before in my life. Never even got pulled over before in my life. So he was like, you know, I'm gonna call this in, see if we can, you know, work something out. They try to, you know, acting like they're doing me a favor, I guess. I give them credit for it. So they're like, you know, you're going too fast. We can't give you a warning. So we're going to give you this $100 ticket. So we're going to give you this $100 ticket and 2 points on your license. So they were like, you can either A, take the ticket like everybody else does and pay it and be on your way, or B, check this box here, mail it in, and go to court. So me personally, I've never gotten a ticket before in my life. I know it's not a huge deal. I just was traumatized. I was completely traumatized. I was like, oh gracious, they're gonna take my bike away. They're gonna take my license away. I'm a worrywart. That's just the way I am. But obviously they're not gonna take my bike and they're not gonna take my license. It's a freaking $100 ticket. It's not really a big deal. So what I did, you know, I talked to some people. I'm gonna take it to court. I'm not fighting the ticket. I was obviously doing 80 and a 55. No one's questioning that. I just want to see if the judge will knock out a few points for me, or at least reduce the ticket. The ticket's only $100. It's not that much money. But I just don't want my insurance to go up astronomically high. So if the judge, he or she, if you know, they knock it down to like no points and just a fine, okay, cool. That would be ideal, honestly. It'll be even better if they threw it out, but if I'm hoping the fact that I'm going to court will appease them in some way, that they reduce my busted piece of paper a little bit. Either or, it, you know, I can handle an increase in insurance. You know, as long as they don't do something crazy. If my insurance companies decide to do something crazy, then yeah, I'm gonna switch insurance, because one ticket is really not a big deal. Especially a $100 ticket is not a big deal. So we'll see what they say, and I'll definitely keep you guys updated. I know I haven't made a video in a while. I've been busy with all kinds of crap, and as you can tell, I'm paranoid about cops now. That's another thing. Cops in Maryland have stepped up their game this month. They are everywhere, and I did some research. They're doing an aggressive driving campaign right now. So they're busting you for everything. Anything and everything you're getting busted for like the next 2 months. Hopefully it'll end soon, but it is crazy. And that contributed to why those cops were in the middle of freaking Nowheresville at that time in the morning, which they never are. So, you know, I give those cops credit for being extra nice. I'm not gonna fight the ticket, as in I'm not gonna protest the ticket. I'm just going to go to court and try to get it reduced. You know, I got busted, you got me. As fast as I usually go, I say that's pretty good that they busted me only going that fast. But yeah, it'll all work out. It always does. I'm not too stressed about it. But I am being more careful. I'm gonna be a lot more cautious in the next videos that I show you guys. I'll still cruise the back roads as usual, but I probably won't be going as fast, just for a little bit, until these popo chill out a bit. Yeah, that's the plan anyway. But yeah, we'll see how it goes. I'll keep you guys updated. Check my Twitter, @MotoHDDK, and I'll keep all the details on there. I'll probably do a video or two. And, oh, nice bike. While you're at it, check out my other videos. I have tutorials that matter and reviews that matter coming up soon. As always, thank you for watching another episode of Moto HD DK, and I'll catch y'all laters.